fire hose words.
Holding others at bay. But eventually I realized that she started talking
to invite others to talk. And then she
became a listener, and her invitation was accepted. In her best conversations, my mother invited another to join her in discovering the bigger world. One that lay beyond their individual horizons.
A bigger world that they just made up. Like a dangerous revelation.
Yes, I do like the light. What else? Yes, I am pompous enough to like talking about things I don't actually
understand, like the Frankfurt School and complexity theory.
Yes, I like it. We become so anxious about our own revelations that we
forget the invitation in conversation, if accepted, is reciprocal. When we don't
use our questioning form that might be revealed by the other person. Heisenberg tells us that what we observe is not nature itself, but nature exposed to our method of questioning. So if listening requires any questioning, let it be gentle. Revelation occurs when we are in real conversation. When we're putting something out there, maybe at our most creative, when we listen and speak without motives or expectations, when we and another just float up balloons, watch them in the breeze, bat around some ideas, stories, jokes. Listening is half that conversation. It's the invitation. Listening is how we escape ourselves and reveal what is outside of us.
Right off the top, to understand people.